Welcome back, everyone, to another phenomenal episode of We Speak Dispatch, where we're talking dispatch and we're talking your language. So today, just a quick snippet, because it is going to be during the holidays, is it's time for us to play the dispatcher's favorite game, Gunshots or Fireworks? Because we all know about this time of year, that's all you hear. And people are calling, and it's just the thing that happens when you're working the holidays. So just curious, because we all work in different size agencies or worked in different size agencies. And, you know, how do you work it at your center? So, Joe, tell us, what is the 4th of July like where you work?
Well, it's probably different than what most people are like, because our 911 center is centrally located downtown. And we are right on a river with an amphitheater. And so a lot of times they'll have concerts up until it gets dark. And then the community all comes downtown. So we got, you know, several thousand people right outside the police department. And they're listening to the concert and it gets loud. And it's also usually our second busiest day pre-COVID. Our busiest day is St. Patrick's Day, where we have a big parade. And it's one of the largest St. Patrick's Day parades in the world. I think it's a top 10.
Wow.
Back to the 4th of July. So when it goes dark, they like to shoot off the fireworks from one of the nearby bridges that goes over the river. So they're going up and they're right outside the dispatcher's windows. I mean, we can see them, hear them going off. And they, you know, so between the amphitheater concert taking calls and then the loud booms and then the phone calls on top of it reporting gunshots or fireworks, it's a interesting display for us when we're working for the July 4th.
Oh my God, that's crazy.
And are you concerned that any of those fireworks or any of those things are going to like come into a window or land on a roof or something like that?
Yeah, in years past, I think they may have moved it just a little bit further away, but in years past, there were volunteers that we have. We have a volunteer corps that would sit out on our roof with buckets of water just to be safe. But I don't think we've ever had to use them. I don't think we've ever had to use them.
That is crazy.
It's like the fire brigade for the building.
No kidding. So what about you, John? Do you have a big 4th of July event where you are?
There's several places within the county that have fireworks displays, typically the townships or private country clubs that we are aware of, kind of thing, and we know the times. And the good thing is that they're spaced out, so they're not all on July 4th.
Right.
But that favorite dispatch game kind of goes on for about 2 or 3 days for us.
Oh,
But of course, the 4th is the big displays and whatever.
Oh, sure.
Yeah,
sure.
But yeah, I mean, we don't have a big display. The only thing close to Joe that we have is the stand across the street.
Oh, the where they sell the stuff. Wow.
You
can actually buy fireworks where you are. Wow. That's, that's a unique
thing. What about you, Doug? Because you're now in a state that, you know, you drive down the freeway and there's like fireworks warehouses.
That's true. Middle Tennessee here is awesome, but this is going to be my first 4th of July. Well, that's kind of. We moved last 4th
because,
of July.
Yeah, last 4th didn't count because of the pandemic.
And I was driving a Penske truck at that point to move us here. Oh,
but, don't talk about it.
Yeah, I don't want to talk about that. But I know they have Nashville has a huge event going on. They're going to close the entire streets and this big old thing going on, which is great. But where I worked in LA, there were no fireworks allowed. You couldn't buy them. They didn't sell them. None. Basically, when I was a kid, we had those one of those safe and sane fireworks.
Oh, yeah.
Where it's like basically a sparkler and you're like, oh, this is exciting. So we just didn't have a lot of that stuff. But when I worked in LA as a dispatcher, that's when we would have the gunshot game, because that was East LA and South LA. And that was, you know, a lot of that. And it was hard to, when you have 1,000 phone calls ringing and you're telling somebody like, it's the 4th of July.
I mean,
it's kind of a thing going on out there. It's like, I know it's illegal to have them in LA County, but it was like, people are still shooting stuff off. Hopefully it's only fireworks and not, you know, an AK-47
right.
or something.
Right. Well, and you bring up a good point, because, you know, in our minds, the people who are sitting at the workstations fielding on those calls, you are saying to yourself, it is the 4th of July.
Yeah.
This should not, comes on July 4th every year, but you've got to be really careful to not get complacent.
Yep.
Because what if you guess wrong? Mm-hmm. Oh, it's just fireworks. Oh, it wasn't. And so that's, I think we can all attest to that challenge, pushing it out to those of you who are going to be working on the 4th. Yes, it's going to be crazy. And yes, you're going to get a lot of calls, but remember the continuity of service doesn't change because it's July 4th.
Yeah.
You've still got to, you got to process those calls because it's not up to us to judge, right? Even though we probably know, 95% of these calls are going to be fireworks.
It's like New Year's Eve. It's like the same principles. It's like people shooting guns off. It's New Year's Eve, for gosh sakes. Give it about two minutes after the hour, they're asleep.
That's right. Just keep yourself safe.
That's right.
And tomorrow it'll be a distant memory.
That's
until
right.
next year.
Comes out. Yeah. Wow. Yeah.
It's tough. It's tough. So for all of you who are working on the 4th, thank you.
Yes,
for putting your citizens and your responders first. We know it's tough and we've all been there. So thank you to all of those of you who are working on July 4th to make it safe for everybody else. We appreciate it. Be strong, you know, service driven, enjoy the time that you have with your family. Come back and listen to us on We Speak Dispatch because we're gonna have all kinds of new topics coming up as things develop, especially as the pandemic goes away. So.
Woohoo!
Giddy up for that. Yeah.
So we'll have our own fireworks.
That's right.
Yes. That's right. Yes, we absolutely will.
I should go buy some
backyard in Tennessee.
Yeah, that's
right. Yes. Okay. So Joe, for those of them. Wow. For the people who aren't normal regular listeners.
Wow.
Where can they find us if they just stumbled across us today?
Well, they're not normal listeners.
We are on Facebook, YouTube, Instagram, and Twitter at We Speak Dispatch.
We're honored tonight.
We're also on several podcast platforms, including Apple Podcasts, iHeartRadio, Spotify, and iHeart, and several other ones. And if you want to be a guest on here, don't hesitate to email us at WeSpeakDispatch@gmail.com or message us on Facebook and we'll get back in touch with you. And thank you to everybody for working on the 4th of July.
Happy 4th, everybody.
Happy 4th.
Happy 4th.